Getting your existing customers to return and buy from you again is one of the smartest and most strategic ways to boost your Etsy shop. You've probably heard the phrase, work smarter, not harder. Well, this is one way to do exactly that. So today I want to share four easy tips that will ensure that your current customers will come back for more, increasing your Etsy sales in the process. Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Kate. I'm so glad you're here. I'm a wife, a mom, an Etsy seller, and a business coach, and I have this channel to come alongside you in your Etsy journey to give you some tips and tricks and strategies that work for me, and I hope will work for you to bring you to the point of success in your Etsy shop. So of course, if you're not subscribed to the channel, I would love for you to do that. Just hit the subscribe button and click the little bell to turn on your notifications. I have some awesome tips for you guys today, but first let's quickly hop over to the computer for our shop shout out of the week.
Congratulations to Yellow Whale Studios CR. Thanks for being part of our channel family. Make sure to comment below for a chance for your Etsy shop to be featured on our next video.
Okay, I know you're ready to dive into these four tips, but I did want to mention, I think the fourth one is probably the best, so make sure to stick around all the way to the fourth one. Okay, so number one is you want to pick a seasonal or a gifting niche. When you're deciding on what type of product you're going to offer, you want to pick a niche or a category that is seasonal and based on holidays and seasons, or gifting, which means that people can come back to you over and over again to purchase gifts for different people at different times, for different holidays or birthdays, whatever it might be. So one example of the difference here would be like if you offered furniture. A piece of furniture is a major purchase for someone that they're probably only going to be doing once every several years. It's not like they're going to be coming back month after month for new furniture. But if you offer something like mugs for different occasions or jewelry or gift sets or holiday baskets, things like that, that people are going to need time after time, year after year, season after season. Of course, there's nothing wrong with offering products that are more of a huge long-term investment purchase, but you're probably not going to be getting a lot of return customers as often as you would with some of these other categories. Shoppers who buy on Etsy for seasonal things will come back time after time. The question is if they'll come back and return to you. You want to do all you can to bring that customer back to your shop, which leads into our next point. And that is that you need to have multiple touch points beyond the first purchase. A touch point is when you're communicating with the customer, you're having another point of contact to remind them of you, of your shop, of the great experience they had there, so that when they come back to shop in the future, they'll more likely remember you. The more touch points you can create ahead of time and have set up ready to go, the better. These can be anything from a follow-up message that is emailed to them after their first purchase, to sending them a discount code or a coupon code for a future purchase, directing them to your social media handles, getting them signed up for your newsletter. There are lots of different ways to ensure that you have multiple touch points and multiple ways to communicate and further that relationship. An email list or a newsletter is a great way to keep in touch with your customers. So the way that you would have them sign up for your newsletter or your email list is to offer them an incentive or a freebie of some sort. So it could be a coupon code for a certain percentage off. It could be a free item that you're going to email them, a digital download, something that you can offer them to incentivize them to give you their email to add to the list. That way you're not losing contact with them after that first transaction, but you're able to reach out to them to communicate about future deals, future sales that you're running, or any promotions that you might be offering to draw them back in as a return customer.
There's a really great built-in place if you go to your settings and you click on info and appearance. This is where you can come up with a shop announcement. You can create a message to your buyers, which is included on the receipt pages and in the emails that buyers receive when they purchase from your shop. So these two sections right here are a great place to announce your social media handles, as well as put the link for people to sign up for your newsletter or your email list. So if you're interested in creating a thank you coupon that'll be sent to your buyers after they've made their original purchase, you just go to your marketing tab, sales and coupons, and then you're gonna go to post purchase thank you, set up campaign, and this is where you can decide what type of offer you want to send to your buyers as a thank you. So you can do a percentage off, you could offer free shipping on a future purchase, a fixed amount off. So let's say you want to do 20% off. Okay, and then you can choose if you want there to be a minimum order to qualify. You want to make sure this box is checked. Yes, automatically send this coupon to buyers within 2 weeks after an order's estimated delivery. And then of course you'll choose your start day and your finish day, or you can choose no end date if you want it to continue. And then you're going to name your code. So let's just say thanks 20. And then that will send out a thank you coupon to every person after they purchase.
The goal here is just not to let the communication and the contact stop beyond that first original purchase, but to continue reaching out to them and developing that relationship for the long term. All right, moving on to tip number 3, and that is to offer awesome customer service. I really can't stress how important this is. You want to promise and deliver. This means if you have a certain time frame, you've promised the buyer you'll ship within, that you keep to that time frame. And if anything ever goes off, that you go above and beyond to make things right with your buyer. You want to make sure to be super responsive to every message or email that comes through and respond in a really timely manner, really kind, really professional, really helpful. Now, there may be situations where something goes wrong and maybe it's not your fault. Maybe the shipping is delayed, or maybe something's broken or damaged during shipping and it's not because of anything that you did. But the key to offering great customer service is to do your best to make the customer feel like they're being taken care of and that you're resolving the situation. Even if it wasn't your fault, you need to go the extra mile to make sure that that customer ends up satisfied. This could actually take a 1-star review to a 5-star review and save you that feedback that's gonna provide social proof for you in the future. So even if it's frustrating, even if it costs you a little bit to fix the situation, you want to make sure to do that because it could save you that 5-star review and it's totally worth it in the end. If you offer great customer service, you're more likely to have return customers because they feel safe coming back to purchase from you again. Okay, and number 4, which I really want you to lean into because this is so important, you're going to work hard to build the know, like, and trust factor with your buyers. We're talking about loyalty here. We want our customers to start to develop a sense of loyalty to us and our brand so that they return for more. The main way to create loyalty with someone that you don't even know that's just now purchased from you is to develop and build that know, like, and trust factor. If you've never heard of know, like, trust, it's definitely something that's been proven in the world of sales to bring people back to you more and to create that loyalty to your brand. So I want you to think of this as a chain. The chain is made up of different links. Know, like, and trust. Your buyer first has to know about you. If they don't even know your brand exists, they're not gonna be coming to you, right? So you have to be able to get the word out about your brand. So they have to know about your brand. Then it moves to like. They have to actually experience your brand and like it. They have to experience you as a person and like you as a person. If anything about you or your brand turns them off or is offensive or doesn't line up with their personal values, they're not gonna have that like portion of the chain. They have to know and like. And then the third is that they have to trust you. So you move from liking you to trusting you. Liking is a lot of times not enough. They have to trust that what they're purchasing is going to be good quality. They trust that you've done the work to produce it the way you say you're going to produce it, that it's not going to just fall apart when they receive it, all of that. They have to trust that it's a good purchase and they trust you as a brand and you as a person that you're going to stick to your word and everything that you've promised. So how do you build and develop that chain of loyalty? Well, there are 2 great ways that I want to focus on, which I mentioned before, but I'm going to expound a little bit. So that's social media and an email list. These are both great ways to develop that more personal connection with your audience and with your buyers, to hopefully let them in on the behind the scenes, to let them see you as a person, not just the brand, but who's behind the brand. Who is the person that's actually making these handmade products or designing these things? The more personal connection and interaction you can have with your potential buyers, the better. People like to support real people. It's hard to feel that personal connection when all you see is a company name and a logo, but when you see a video or a photo and the name and the face that's behind that company name and the logo, then they see what their money is going towards, and a lot of times they feel more inclined to support you. So whether you're creating a touch point through social media or through an email list, all of these things can be done through either. So the first thing I want you to think about is initiating a 2-way conversation. This means that you're not just preaching at people, you're not just putting sales in front of their face. You're not just putting your product out there, but you're asking them questions about what they like and what they value, what styles are good to them. You're initiating that back and forth conversation so that they feel like they're being heard. They feel like their opinion matters to you and that you care about them. The next thing I want to mention is being generous. This means that you're showing your appreciation by offering giveaways sometimes or discounts or sales. You're offering these things to your buyers to show them that you appreciate them, that you love them as your audience, and that you're wanting to give back. Generosity really does go a long way in terms of bringing people back as return customers and developing that loyalty to your brand. Remember, don't be stingy. When you're doing giveaways and discounts, give them something good. Give your best. That really shows authenticity and that you truly do care for them. Okay, here's a big one. You want to avoid salesy jargon and just keep it real. You want to keep it simple and be really approachable to people. This means that you're not coming across as a pushy salesperson, but you're coming across as a real person who's being authentic and transparent and just keeping it real. So people are really drawn to that a lot more than if they can tell you're just being pushy and trying to push your product onto them. Okay, and like I mentioned before, you want to let them see behind the scenes. A lot of times people love seeing the process that goes into the production of your items that you're selling. They want to see your machinery, your equipment, your whole process for how you make these things or design these things. They like to see what the process is behind the scenes, and you letting them into that world only creates more of that like, know, and trust factor because you're letting them in, so then they feel safe letting you in. So I hope these four strategies help you in getting some of your current customers to return and buy from you again and boost your Etsy shop and your Etsy sales with return business. If you're new here and you haven't watched our Etsy playlist, I have a ton of other Etsy strategy videos that can really help you level up your Etsy shop. So you can click or tap the screen right here. It'll take you to another video just like this one. See you next time, friends.